Almost a year after the 2016 presidential election, evidence of Russian meddling continues to dribble out. Before he left office, President Barack Obama launched the first salvo in what would become a diplomatic tit-for-tat, ordering two Russian compounds in the U.S. closed. This is one of them. This plush 45-acre waterfront spread on Maryland's eastern shore has served as a retreat for Russian diplomats since the early 70s.
For the most part, they stayed to themselves. My son went up there and asked the security guards if the Russians would like to play soccer. They have a beautiful soccer field. The guy says, no way, that's not going to happen.
The property originally belonged to Jacob Raskoff, a wealthy industrialist who built the Empire State Building. Compound, located in the town of Centreville, about 1 hour from Washington, D.C., includes two large main houses, 10 guest houses, 4 tennis courts, 2 pools, a boathouse, and a private beach.
I really never, ever felt there would be any counterintelligence. I mean, first thing, we're out in the middle of nowhere.
The most recent assessed tax value was $8.7 million. When Obama kicked the Russians off the compound, he said that it and another diplomatic residence in Long Island was used for, quote, intelligence-related purposes, unquote.
It wasn't what I thought it would be. There was no, like, secret operatives walking around. It wasn't like these covert tunnels that we could find and all that. It just seemed like a normal house, a normal place of kind of rest and relaxation out there in the countryside.
If there were intelligence activities happening on the compound, it's likely the U.S. government knew about it. A property that borders the compound is still registered to the State Department, and the FBI openly watched the compound in the 70s and 80s.
At one point, I had talked to the district FBI superintendent, who told me they had contemplated a number of techniques of surveillance, one of which he said perhaps they could put a submarine in the river and keep an eye on them from that, which was an idea of some comic superiority because the river is only 10 feet deep.
If the Trump administration wants to return the compound to the Russians, it must get permission from Congress, which seems unlikely at the moment. According to a spokesman for Maryland Senator Ben Cardin, quote, the senator believes there is no scenario in which the compound should be returned to the Russians. He does not believe they have been held accountable for their attack on our election, unquote. For now, the compound sits empty, the casualty of a diplomatic standoff with no end in sight. For Russians still posted to their embassy in D.C., they'll have to look elsewhere for weekend fun.